Now we shall discuss two more questions from that exercise. Question number 6. Given dy by dx equals 1 plus x square into 1 plus y square.
We have to find the
solution of this differential equation. Just cross multiply. Dy is equal to 1 plus x square into 1 plus y square dx. Dividing by 1 plus y square, we get dy by 1 plus y square is equal to 1 plus x square dx. We shall integrate both sides. Integral dy by 1 plus y square is equal to integral 1 plus x square dx. Now integral dy by 1 plus y square is tan inverse y, because derivative of tan inverse y with respect to y is 1 by 1 plus y square. Therefore, on the left, it is tan inverse y. On the right, integral 1 dx is x, integral x square dx is x cube by 3, and this constant of integration. Okay, now coming to question number 7, it is y log y dx minus x dy equals 0. We shall divide by dy dx, because it is y dx and x dy. With y we must get dy, and with x we need to get dx. Therefore, dividing by dy dx, y log y by dy minus x by dx equals 0. We shall shift this x by dx to the right and take the reciprocal of the left and right. That is, dy by y log y is equal to dx by x. Now it is in the variable separable form. We can integrate. Integrate in both sides. Now this dy by y can be put as 1 by y dy divided by this log y. Is the same. This is expressed in this form to make it easier for integration. Now consider log y. Derivative of log y with respect to y is 1 by y. In the numerator we have the derivative of the denominator. In such case, the answer is log modulus denominator. Integral f of x, f dot x divided by f of x dx. The answer is log modulus f of x plus c. Now here it is in that form. Derivative of log y is here, 1 by y. Therefore, integral of the left side is log denominator, that is log y, is equal to, here it is, log mod x plus constant of integration. That can be put as log c, no problem. A number. Now, log a plus log b is equal to log ab, that is log cx. Log y, it is modulus log y is equal to log modulus x plus log c. Log y is equal to log cx. Therefore, log y is equal to cx. Log y is equal to log cx. Therefore, log y. And we know the base for this log y is e. Log y to the base e is equal to cx. Therefore, y must be e raised to cx. If log y is equal to cx, then e raised to cx must be y. That is the base we learnt in logarithm of a number to some base. if logarithm of m to the base a is equal to x, then m is equal to a raised to x. Here the base is e, therefore y is equal to e raised to cx. Right.